In this video, we are going to see OSPF protocol. OSPF protocol works in the network layer, and it is nothing but open shortest path first protocol, which is intra autonomous system routing protocol that exists in the autonomous system to find the shortest path between the nodes inside the same autonomous system. So we can use two protocols for finding the shortest path within the autonomous system. One is RIP, which I have posted in the last video, and the next protocol, the next example of intra autonomous system routing protocol is OSPF. So why it is called open shortest path first is, since it is available publicly, it can be called as open shortest path first routing algorithm. So how can we find the shortest path within the autonomous system with the help of OSPF? See, we are going to use link state routing algorithm to find the shortest path. In the RIP, we used distance vector routing algorithm, whereas in the OSPF, we are going to use link state routing algorithm. Link state is nothing but Dijkstra's routing algorithm. Then how the Dijkstra's algorithm finds the shortest path, as we have already discussed in the previous videos which I have posted. So it is going to use LS packet, that is link state packet dissemination. Then every node will be having their own topology map, and the route computation, the routes are computed using Dijkstra's algorithm. So first it has to disseminate the link state packets, and every node, with the help of that, every node will be having how it is connected to other nodes in that particular network. And after having the idea of the connectivity, its own connectivity to other nodes in that network, it will find the shortest path using Dijkstra's algorithm. Clear? Next comes OSPF advertisement carries one entry per neighbor. So whereas in the previous RIP we saw 25 entries are allowed, here OSPF advertisement carries only one entry per neighbor, and advertisements flooded to entire autonomous system. So if in the autonomous system we have 4-5 routers, to all the routers the advertisement will be flooded. It is carried in OSPF messages directly over IP. So the advertisements are carried in the OSPF messages. So here also UDP, either TCP or UDP is used, but UDP is better since there is no need of acknowledgement or no guaranteed services required. Here we can go with the UDP protocol to send the advertisement, OSPF advertisement. So the first step I said, right, link state packet dissemination. What is that? See here, so we have 4 nodes in a network, we'll assume, and this node will not be knowing how it is connected to these nodes and what is the cost. So if it knows only about its neighbor, like it is directly connected to the neighbor, we'll assume it is A and this is B and this is C and D. A knows that it is directly connected to 1 with the cost of 1, B with the cost of 1, and it is also directly connected to C with the cost of 2. So what it will do, it will send the advertisement to B that I am directly connected to B with the cost 1. Then B will send the same advertisement to D that A is connected directly, A can be reached through me with the cost of 1. So what D will do, it will update in its routing table that A can be reached through B, next node will be B, with the cost of whatever cost it is there. If we assume that it is 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So D will be making this entry. So the advertisement which was sent by A to B is called link state packet dissemination. And now D came to know that it is directly connected to B and B is connected to A. So what it will assume? It will assume that this is the topology. So I am connected to B. So D assumes that D is connected to B and B is connected to A. So what is there in the memory of D? like this. And again, C will send the link state packet message that I am connected to A. Then what D will do? Then it will update in its memory that C is connected to D and C is directly connected to A. So whatever the exact node network is there, that will be known by every node or the router, that how is their topology, how every node is connected to other node in the network. So I'll be having, if I'll imagine like I'm the node, so I'll be having the idea that how every node is connected to other node in the network, that is called topology. So this information is called topology map. So D is having the information that this is how I'm connected to, or every node is connected in the same network. And B also will have the idea that this is how all the nodes are connected in its network. And A also will be having the idea that this is how it is connected to all the nodes. So every node will be having the idea of their own topology map. We know, right, how where we are. See, if I'm staying in Bangalore, I know that I'm besides Andhra Pradesh and Kerala. So that will be there in our brain. We know where we are located, the topology map. We know. So like that, every node will be knowing their topology information with the help of link state packet dissemination. Once they get this information, how they are connected. So once I know that how far Kerala is from me, how far is Andhra Pradesh from me, Maharashtra from me, I can now select the best path. Yes or no? If I want to go to Andhra Pradesh, then if I have the map information, map idea, then I can choose the best path, whether through Kerala to Andhra Pradesh is best path, or from Bangalore to Andhra Pradesh direct, which is direct path, is best path. So with the information, with the help of the Dijikstra's algorithm, I can select the best path. So the first step is link state packet dissemination, and the second step is, after getting the idea from the link state packet how every node is connected to other node in the network, I will have the topology of my network. With that, I will find the shortest path using Dijikstra's algorithm. This is how OSPF finds the shortest path between the nodes in the same autonomous system. Yes. So what are the features of OSPF? It provides security. All OSPF messages are authenticated. So it is malicious. It can prevent malicious intrusions, and multiple same cost paths are also allowed. But among the same cost path, it can select one path. Whereas in a RIP, we have only one path. For each link, multiple cost matrix for a different time of service is done. Then integrated unicast and multicast is supported. A hierarchical OSPF is also used if it is of large domain. What is hierarchical OSPF? See, this is hierarchical OSPF, in which if the domain is larger, we can divide it into areas, and every area is connected to other area with the help of the area border router and the backbone routers. The routers which connects all the areas are called backbone areas. See, these are the backbone areas. So these are the area 1, 2 and 3. How this area is connected to backbone is with the help of the area border router. And for this area, this is area border router, and for this area, this is the area border router. So if you take this entire autonomous system, how it can be connected to other autonomous system is with the help of the boundary router. So boundary router helps to communicate with the other autonomous system. If you find, this is autonomous system 1. If the autonomous system 1 size is larger, then we will be dividing into areas. Every area will be having area border router, which helps to communicate with the other areas through backbone routers. See, through backbone routers, we can communicate with the other areas with the help of the border routers. If I want to communicate, if the router in the area 1 wants to communicate with the router in the other autonomous system. First it has to communicate to area border router, then backbone router, then backbone router to boundary router, from the boundary router to again its own backbone router, boundary router, then boundary router to backbone router to area border router, then area border router to that particular router. So this is how the communication takes place using hierarchical OSPF. Okay, with this I'm ending this session. Thank you, bye.